And there was a gentleman who's not here, but who said a wonderful thing that his editor had told him, that there are only three things, yaad rakhna. And he said, when you meet somebody, hawa bharo, gubara banao, or sulj balo. So, you know, a lot of journalism is that. And I thought it was wonderful and I loved it. It was just a great formula. So the next time a journalist approaches you, remember this.
No,
they're nice guys too.
Ninal, you said that you wrote that book while the trial was on.
Yes.
So now that the judgment is out and
yes.
It has been quite some time.
Yes.
You think there are certain things which you now think that you could have written in a different way, or you would have added certain things at that point of time?
No. The only thing I wish I had done was that I wish I had written it slightly better. You know, that's it. In terms of information and fact, there is nothing that I would change. But yes, of course, it's like you know, you wince at over a phrase and you think, "Arey, ye nahi likhna chahiye tha, wo likhna chahiye tha." But which I'll briefly talk about, one of the very interesting challenges for me writing the book was the language. See, we are all, most of us here are perhaps better reader than writers. We are good readers. I mean, you know, we understand literature, we understand things, we appreciate good writing, and I'm no different. But you see, the thing with nonfiction also is that you also have to represent the voice of the person you are speaking to. And we are really in the midst of a great crisis of language. And so that was one of the things, and I wish that I had written the book slightly better. But factually, no, I don't think there's any.
And the perception about the characters that remains the same.
No, that's... Though I must say that, you know, there was Emile Jerome was one character to whom I did not have too much access. And I wish I had better access to him. Perhaps I could have done a more rounded portrayal of him.
Where is he?
He's in jail in Kolhapur.
And do you intend to do any sequel to it now?
No sequel to it. If at all I write something, it will be not about murder and all, hopefully. The killing, yes.
Minil ji, meri baaton ka koi aur arth nahi lijiyega.
Nahi, zarur.
Samjhne ke liye. Jaisa abhi aapne ishara bhi kiya ki journalist jis tarah se kaam karte hain. और जिस कहानी को आपने कहा उसके कारण क्या थे, कैसे छोटी जगह से लोग आते हैं एस्पिरेशन लेके और कुछ बनना चाहते हैं, मुझे नहीं मालूम कि आपने इस बात को, और आपने पोस्ट लिबरलाइजेशन की भी बात की, उसको आपने ज़्यादा डिटेल में लिया कि नहीं, शायद कहानी ही कही है, लेकिन क्या आपको नहीं लगता कि ये कहानी, उसके ऊपर लिखी गई ये किताब आपकी तरफ से नहीं, जिन्होंने आपसे लिखवाई, और उस पर जो फिल्म बनाने जा रहे हैं या बनाई, वे सब एक ही चीज़ के हिस्से हैं, एक ही प्रोसेस के हिस्से हैं, और जहाँ उसमें जो मरने और जीने वाले हैं उनकी कोई खास जगह नहीं है, सब लोग अपना अपना उसमें
किरदार निभा रहे हैं
और लाभ कमा रहे हैं।
हाँ, आप एक तरह से बिल्कुल सही फरमा रहे हैं, पर एक बात और भी है कि आप ये जो मैं जर्नलिज्म के बारे में जो कह रही थी, पत्रकारिता के बारे में, वो एक इंटरेस्टिंग ये है कि लोग क्यों फिर भी, ऐसा नहीं है कि लोगों को मालूम नहीं है कि पत्रकार उनका फ़ायदा उठा रहे हैं, पर फिर भी लोग बात करना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि एक तो होता है कि एक जो होता है कि जो कि शोहरत चाहते हैं, वो उसकी मैं बात नहीं कर रही हूँ, पर एक हम सब में एक बहुत एक नीड होती है कि कोई हमारी सुने, और इंक्रीजिंगली हम एक ऐसे वर्ल्ड में रह रहे हैं जहाँ पे शायद कम्युनिकेशन में कुछ तो दरार आई है, और जैसे कि नीरज के पेरेंट्स मैं बता रही हूँ, जैसे उनका लॉस इतना ज़्यादा था, अभी भी उनके पिताजी जो है मेरे को फ़ोन करते हैं, और क्योंकि मतलब उनको लगता है कि किसी तरह से हमारी कोई सुनवाई हो, कोई सुनने वाला हो। और मैं आपको बता रही हूँ, ये जितने भी इसमें लोगों से मैंने बात करी एक आध को छोड़ करके, वो अगर कोई उनको लोगों को मालूम हो कि कोई सचमुच ध्यान दे रहा है और कोई सचमुच इंटरेस्टेड है उनकी लाइफ में, तो अधिकांश लोग खुलते हैं और अपने मन की बात कहते हैं।
नहीं, वो ठीक है कि वो खुलते हैं, और शायद अगर जर्नलिज्म ना हो, मीडिया ना हो, तो हिंदुस्तान जैसे देश में जहाँ
बहुत सारी चीजें जो
बिल्कुल
उजागर होनी चाहिए वो नहीं होती है,
लोगों की सुनने वाला कोई नहीं है, एक मीडिया ही है, चाहे वो किसी वजह से ही जो उनकी आवाज को
नहीं। देखिए, मैं मजाक उड़ा रही हूँ, पर मैं अपना भी मजाक उड़ा रही हूँ, पर मैं इसलिए उड़ा रही हूँ क्योंकि मैं इस पोजीशन से उड़ा रही हूँ क्योंकि मुझे मालूम है कि मीडिया इज अ मोस्ट वंडरफुल थिंग। अब उसका अब्यूज होता है, हर चीज का होता है, पर उसका बहुत सही उपयोग भी होता है, एंड इट्स एक्चुअली अ मार्वेलस थिंग टू बी अ जर्नलिस्ट।
यस, बट ये चीज इसमें जोड़नी पड़ेगी, हालांकि ये जर्नलिज्म के बारे में नहीं, मैं बात समाप्त कर रहा
हूँ। हाँ जी।
और वो ये है कि जर्नलिस्ट की जो सामाजिक छवि थी वो नीचे की ओर आई
है, बहुत धूमिल हो गई।
और दूसरी बात ये कि जो आपने ये विषय उठाया है, ये सही है, पिछले सालों में ये अर्बन क्राइम बढ़ा है और चंडीगढ़ में भी ऐसे कई केसेस हुए।
जी जी जी।
और ये सचमुच में सोशियोलॉजिस्ट के लिए स्टडी की चीज है, लेकिन ये बहुत पुरानी चीज भी है। आपने भी इशारा किया, वो पुराना एक वो भी है, इडियम भी है, जर जोरू और जमीन। बिल्कुल, वो इस तरह की बात करता है। और इससे पहले नैना सानी का केस,
जी बिल्कुल,
और उससे पहले वो जो बैडमिंटन खिलाड़ी थी
सैयद मोदी,
हालांकि उस समय पॉलिटिशियन पावर पॉलिटिशियन के पास ज्यादा थी, और आज शायद
नहीं। तो वही तो इंटरेस्टिंग ये यही था कि ये जो तीन लोग थे, ये ऐसे लोग हैं जो हमारे बच्चे हो सकते थे, जिनको आप अगर कॉफी हाउस में जाएं तो वो आपके बगल में बैठे हों। तो द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग इज कि दिस इनहेरेंट वायलेंस, द क्वालिटी, दिस मलेवोलेंस, दिस डार्कनेस, ये हम सब में है, और किस सर्कमस्टांसिस में निकल आए पता नहीं। यस,
very quick. Well, I'm a theater professor, and I have been teaching for the last 30 years. And so many of my students, especially the female ones, they've gone to Mumbai. I don't want to have the long list of the people who are still here, superstars also. Those girls come to me because they have special attachment. You know, in the process of, you know, getting a chance, a break, they encounter such people and they come to me for advice. So in your book, you know, when you talk about death, I love the title, because it's not just a death of a, you know, girl, but it's the death of the soul that you go to.
It's multiple levels. Yeah. Yes.
And I have seen my own students, they are qualified, they are postgraduate, whether they become 10th assistant to it, and they are, you know, like spot boys, and, you know, distributing tea and all. So they come to me, and have you ever touched upon this, the ethics of this profession? You know, they must evolve some ethics. You know, they must not compromise.
And I think a lot has changed. I think a lot of the sort of, you know, a lot has changed. You know, what the earlier, you know, this whole cliche of the casting couch, I'm sure it's still there, but I think there are a lot of directors, a lot of mainstream directors who are far more professional, because I think there is a certain degree of professionalism. And that, see, in India, the whole idea of patronage, whether it was zamindari ka tha ya patriarchy ka tha, we've always had unequal power hierarchies. This has been a continuation of that unequal power hierarchy. But I think, like everything is democratizing, I think even democratizing is greater professionalism. But yes, but you know, this kind of exploitation can be at many levels. For instance, it's not just about sexual exploitation. It can be exploitation about money. I mean, we do know that, you know, young people who go in, people are not paid for many months, and, you know. Yeah, I mean, that's you know, but I think that kind of exploitation, you know, that has to be brought at an individual level. Where I'm very hopeful. I think there is a lot of change happening. Really, it's just that, you know, it's people are making perhaps different kinds of compromises. Maybe they're compromising on the kind of work that they do, not necessarily. It's not just sexual, is what I'm trying to say.
Right, absolutely right. And the girls must not present themselves so vulnerable and weak. And sometimes it's their fault.
Yeah, and sometimes they go like, what, yeah. That Ram Gopal Varma, when I met him, he told me that he was very surprised that a lot of women come to him assuming that, haan, ye toh karna hi padega, aur kya karna padega. So, you know, this assumption, the girls or the men, they can be exploitation of all kinds, I think everybody should just as there is an exploiter, there is an exploited. Both need to refuse to be exploited or to exploit.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm just reminded of two lines which Kefi asked me.
Ji, zarur.
When he says to a woman, "Uth meri jaan mere saath hi chalna hai tujhe. Kalbe mahol mein larza sharare jang hai aaj. Aapki noon mein tapa balwale sang hai aaj. Jis mein jalta hoon usi aag mein jalna hai tujhe. Uth meri jaan mere saath hi chalna hai."
Absolutely.
So the woman has to be as strong.
Yes, absolutely.
As the man.
Yeah.
And should not think, I have to compromise, I have to surrender myself, unless and until they have this woman liberation. The real woman liberation will come into the, ye nahi, bindaas ho jao,
Sleep with anybody,
I'm liberated.
That's a false reading of modernity.
That is the concept which is prevailing.
I think which we need to teach our girls that.
Yeah,
we need to teach our girls not to do that.
Yeah.
Sure. Thank you, ma'am, for this excellent session. We now request Mr. Mithun Dixit, Director of the Foundation, to hand over the token of gratitude to...
Before that, I just want to say a very, very quick thanks to Mr. Dixit and to the entire team. It's been wonderful and really appreciated. It was a great idea to do this the festival in this format. And Chandigarh is a great city, and really, thank you. Deeply appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Well, can't believe that the morning went by so fast. It's been another riveting day at CLF, and there's more to come. We have a break now, and the next session for the book M and the Big Home starts at 2:15 at the Lawns. Meanwhile, there's yet another interesting session going on at the Lawns. You all are requested to head towards the Lawns. Thank you.